Today I'm going to change this to this. The Victory Tech Super String Steel Sheet. I'm going to test the first layer adhesion with PTG, ABS and PLA. Stay tuned! Hello friend, welcome back. It's nice to see you here watching this video. Today we're going to test this build plate from Victory Tech. But first, let's see some specifications of this product.
On AliExpress, we find the BQ Super String Steel Sheet in the Victory Tech official store. In this product, you can choose from three versions: all the build plate and the magnetic part to stick on the aluminum bed for printers such as Ender 3 which do not bring magnetic bed, and other version only with springs to fix the build plate on the bed. Victory Tech says that the build plate has a good adhesion and is resistant to high temperatures. The size is 235 by 245 mm. The material is special steel and it supports up to 100 degrees and is ready to print PLA, ABS, TPU and PTG. Again, it's announced that it has a strong adhesion and that while the bed is hot, the print will not come off easily. This is what we're going to test. Are flexible to lose easily the prints. To test the strong adhesion, we prepared Infusion 360, a layer difficult to print. Let's try it.
Everything is ready, let's start the test with PLA.
To ensure that the bed is well leveled, I will use AutoLev sensor for auto bed leveling. If you want to know more about this sensor, I will leave the link on the video description. I want to mention that I didn't use any additives on the build plate, like air sprays or any type of glues. All tests will be carried out without any additives, to know if the build plate is really good as mentioned, and to be a fair test. As you can see there at the first point, my nozzle is a little high because I changed the build plate and I didn't calibrate anything. I used baby stepping to adjust my Z offset again and everything continued to print well. The print is about to end. As you can see, while the bed is hot, the print does not come off easily. Nice job!
Well, the PLA adhered very well on the bed, better than I was thinking. But let's move on to the PTG, which is more difficult filament to stick on the bed, and see the results.
Let's clean the build plate with alcohol and prepare it for the next print. As you can see, the build plate is completely clean. I will use Fiberlogy PTG filament. Fiberlogy sent me some types of filament to test its quality. So far I have obtained excellent prints with this filament. Soon I will review this filament here on the channel. Again, the filament sticks to the bed stupendously. Even with these circles, the filament glued without any difficulty. As you can see, I didn't have any kind of problem even with PTG. We have a first layer of PTG coming out perfectly. Everything headed well, and we have the finished print. Let's test if the print is easy to take off with the hot bed. As you can see, the PTG is really sticked on the bed. Let's try harder. Finally, some parts started to drop out. I'm really applying a lot of force, and it's still not easy to unstick. I will let the bed cool down to test. Now with the cold bed, notice how print comes out easily. I never test anything like that. I'm amazed at how easily the parts peel off.
Until now, what do you think about this product? At least magnificent. But I'm so excited, let's test it with the ABS.
To test ABS, I had to switch to my closed printer. Again, the filament stuck to the bed without any problem. I used it 100 degrees on the bed to test the ABS, and no damage happened to the build plate. As you can see, I have a perfect first layer and well glued on the bed again. The printing is over and let's remove the build plate and see how our print looks. I'm using a paper because the build plate is really hot. Again, with the hot build plate, it's not easy to remove the print. And here we have our print already with the build plate cooled. Nice first layer. I found that the ABS are a little harder to detach from the build plate. But I still managed to take it off just using my hands. I'm testing taking off without flexing the build plate. But as the build plate gets colder, it's easy to start taking the print. I'm going to clean the build plate again with alcohol and I check it that it's ready again to receive the next print.
Definitely, this build plate will be a part of my printer. Guys, give me your opinion what you think about this build plate on the comments below. Special thanks to Victory Tech who has sent me this build plate to test and review. If you like this video, give that thumbs up, subscribe the channel, ring that bell for when I upload the new content, you get a notification. See you at the next one. Until there, a big hug to all of you, and bye.